Now, welcome back, guys. You know, everyone nowadays has a cell phone. This is true, especially in Kenya. You got to be careful with that thing. Like, seriously, you have to be careful. It's like our lives just orbit around that rectangular piece of metallic covered circuitry board, sending our voices and texts back and forth in space. I can't disagree, though. I'm one of those people that just can't part with my phone. True story. The only time I put my phone down is when I'm praying. But again, it has to be playing some Ron Kenoly or Alvin Slaughter song to cheer me up. Every few minutes, I'll be checking my phone, like, you know that kamime sound that comes on your phone when messages are coming and somebody's trying to call you. So, Sal, oh, look, I have zero missed calls, zero texts. The Facebook homepage is also quiet whenever I check my phone. Then I remember I have zero incoming calls, zero texts, and I have three friends on Facebook who never miss to like and share whatever I post. Those guys are a package of darlings. I celebrate you guys. But anyways, I'll still be sitting there or standing there, no difference, with my phone, just messing around with it. I have one of those phones with a broken screen after a young one decided to keep it down for me. And I know I'm not alone. Many of you guys have those state-of-the-art phones. Well, you know, guys, how addictive it is just to slide your finger on the phone screen back and forth every day, like shoop, 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 left, right, up, down. It's lots of fun until suddenly you get a call from your mom at 2 a.m. wondering why you called. Hello. Oh, hi, mom. No, I didn't mean, did you call me? No, mom, I didn't call you. I didn't mean to call you, like, no, right now. I didn't mean to call you at 2 a.m. Yes, I know, mom. Yes, I know. I'm in the house, mom. I'm in the house. No, I didn't mean to call you. No. I didn't mean to call. I'm not in jail, mom. I'm not in jail. Mi siko kwa jela, mom. Okay. Right now, I'm in the house. Okay. And then later on, I'm going to bed, getting real sleepy. Then, again, I jump out of bed, wide awake, grab the phone again. I always keep it by me in case my feelings just get hurt or something. And, you know, I just have to cool my mind. You know, just again. I'm going around like a boss, walking majestically like they do in the movies, looking like all cool, like Raila Odinga being endorsed in Central Kenya. You know what I mean? Nothing like a text alert, full volume at 2:30 a.m. in the morning to get the blood flowing, my friend. Someone actually texted me at 2:30 in the morning. So, let's see. I read the message first. It says that I got a friend's suggestion from Facebook. But hey, friend, a friend's suggestion ain't that bad. The worst thing is to hear that friends are dying out there. Nothing worse than a message at 2 a.m. in the morning, and it's a picture of a friend mugged or brutally murdered or simply shot dead. So, there are some things happening in Kenya you don't want to ignore. It's essential to not just sanitize, keep distance, and mask up. You also would want to be safe, guys. The killings and murders are just becoming unbearably saddening. Wakikunyang'anya simu, don't follow them. Run away. They rob you more, you know. A friend told me a joke and said, Bush, don't assist a beggar. Wakowengi, utasota. Don't pay deposits. Landlords ukatalia. Usikopeshane pesa. Watu awalipi, utakosa rafiki na pesa yako. Usipige luku kwa slums, utapigwa ngeta. But on a serious note, guys, from the words of a good pal, Gordon Opio, Kenya arrivals from the US and UK should take time before they freely be moving around. Now, the bikers killed in Kitengela and the 2012 top KCSE student who had just graduated from Yale, killed in Homa Bay, are just recent examples. Coming from the relatively well-secured areas in the West, many make the mistake of forgetting that Kenya is one big crime scene. There are streets you ought not to pass when it's dark. There are roads you should never use during the day. Even in the Nairobi CBD, you stray into those alleys around River Road and Kirinyaga Roads, you will be swept clean, guys. Secondly, as unfortunate as it is, many Kenyans in the villages still consider dreadlocks and rastas to be identity of criminals. Whereas in the United States and UK, dreadlocks are a form of African identity. In places like Kajiado, Narok, and other rural areas, dreadlocks are usually associated with hardcore thugs. So if you arrive from the west, you are safer moving around Karen, Lavington, and other upmarket areas with your dreadlocks. The moment you venture into the rural areas or ghettos like Kayole and Githurai, you become marked man. These are just some basic survival techniques. Remember, Kenya is one big crime scene, so you better take extra caution. Thank you so much, guys. Take care, sanitize, mask up, keep your distance. And if you've not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do so. Like, share, comment. I will definitely talk back to you. My name is Bushebe Jr. See you next time.